Warhol realized that every image that had had the most amount of power was always to do with commodity, fame, and ultimately untimely death. Towards the end of his life, the focus was really turned directly towards him, commoditizing himself, leaving him on the shelves, literally as a product, facing out to the world. It had been some time since Andy Warhol had actually prepared a series of self-portrait paintings. So in 1986, in preparation for a great commercial exhibition, Anthony Dauphé beckoned the artist to make a final series of self-portrait paintings. Warhol worked on a cycle of pictures, the Frightwig self-portraits. What we have in front of us is a ghostly, sincere, and ultimately death-like visage, which precurses the artist's untimely death within the 12 months after the opening of the exhibition. Warhol's fascination with death and disaster had occupied him as an artist since the early 60s, and throughout all of his life, death was never far from the surface. In his own life, he spoke increasingly of the tangible sense of the aging process and confronting mortality. Nowhere is this clearer than in the six panels in this painting. The current owners, visiting Anthony Dauphé's gallery on a Sunday 3 days before the opening of the exhibition, stopped in their tracks as they stood in front of these six pictures. Andy Warhol had specifically put them together in a group and very deliberately given instructions to hang them at exactly his eye height, so that you were hit and confronted immediately by these faces when you stood in front of them. It is truly a rare opportunity to find a series such as this, put together by the artist very deliberately, still intact, and having never been offered on the open market before. The fact that there are six panels and that each one is characterized by an extraordinary and unique color leaves you in no doubt this is an artist at his absolute height confronting death with a motif that is truly unforgettable.